Two Lion Fighting Championships 26, the Summer Showdown. First up, a flyweight amateur MMA contest. Contested over 3 2-minute rounds. Please welcome into the blue corner from the Striking Club, Cager Civic Mission. Again, into the blue corner from the Striking Club, Cages to make a vision. And his opponent in the red corner from Silverbacks MMA, Bradley Barr.
Hello, welcome to Lion Fight Championships 26. We kick it off with a flyweight bout here. Amateur mixed martial arts in the blue corner. Cager Simicovicius from the Striking Club. His opponent in the red, Bradley Bunn from Silverbacks MMA. Looking for the head and arm off this bottom position. Doesn't look like he's got the arm trapped, however. He's breaking the posture well, though. Got to think about the sweeps and the submissions off of his back in this position. Could use the cage as well to get back to his feet. Guard's open. So at this point, one could potentially get that posture, start to fight the leg, and pass the guard into a more favorable position. Some nice body shots there. He's got to keep busy. Nice body shots. Looking to soften him up here. I think he's trying to plan the road for this guard pass when it's more favorable. I mean, at this point, really, opportunity to pass to the right side only with the cage blocking him off on the left side. So he's got to consistently use this ground and pound. He's got to be careful about the triangle attempt here, though. With that arms far, you can hear the corner say the arms too far back. They don't want him to expose the triangle entry. Got to be careful about giving the arms here as well for arm bars and triangles. That's dependent, though, on the blue corner's cage just to open the guard and start to think about submission attacks. And when he does that, he could potentially give up the guard pass. Heavy body shots. Oh, nice body shots, double body shot from that top position. It's so far. Dominated that top position and did a good job of utilizing the ground pound. Ref didn't stand him up. And you see Bradley just really active in that top position in the opening round. It's it for round two here. Flyweight amateur action. It's contested over 3 2-minute rounds. Cages in the blue, Bradley in the red. You saw Bradley in that first round dominate the top position, utilize the ground pound. Nice trip again to that top position. He's going to work in this guard nice and busy here, just like he did in the first round. I would argue a little bit more busy. He's definitely aware of the submission attacks. Stays away from the triangle entries. Listens to his corner as well, which is another skill set that we need to develop as the athletes go through the amateur ranks, to be able to drown out all the white noise and listen to the coach. There's the triangle set up here from that bottom position. So Mickey Vicious looking to push that arm through here, controlling with his body lock, and he's limiting the strikes to the body at least. But at this point in time, the clock's running and we're seeing Bradley in this top position. Now he's threatening the guard pass, slices through. Nice connection with the chest here. Solid side control, educated crowd here in Kent today. Always slice the sweet amount. This is a great position for those body shots. More so favorable here for the submission attacks though. He might look to stay in this top position and control. Could potentially look for the mounted triangle towards the end of the round. See here, he postures up. Of course, under the rule set, no headshots allowed. Younger athletes still developing, still coming through their mixed martial arts journey, so it's important to keep those headshots reserved. He's overhooked the arm here, which says to me he might be looking for a mounted triangle. He's passing the arm across, could be looking to walk up to S mount, going for the Ezekiel choke. Hasn't got a definitive connection on the forearm though. Going for the armbar. I thought he would be going for the submission towards the end of the round, because if it's not fruitful, he ends up in that bottom position. So, and it's great awareness of such young athletes to be able to pick away at the game plan and go for that submission towards the end of the round. Third and final round. Solid work from Bradley so far. Big swing and a miss. Allows the body lock. Passes again to the outside position. Gets the takedown. But we're looking to improve his position as he goes down to the canvas now. I think he's going to start to pull the pressure on. He has the affordance once he frees the head to potentially look for an armbar. But I think he's going to probably try and stay in this top position. He's going to force that arm down into the neck of his opponent to free that head. Of course, he can go to the mount here. Slices through Neon Belly. His great maneuverability. He's looking for the armbar. But he's cautious to keep that top position. I like that readjustment. Cage just not finding the ample opportunities here to open up and try and escape. Eating some body shots. Referee looking on. These punches are getting through. Heavy body shots here from that top position from Bradley. Bradley one corner on the pressure. So Mickey Vicious looking for the escape. He's got to think about the hip escapes here. Now he's got loads of space to try and hip escape and try and capture hold of the half guard. And that would limit Bradley's ability to rain down these punches and lesser submission attacks. He's looking for the sweep. He's got to block the arm and the leg of his opponent, though, to get that top position. Bunn maybe looking for the mounted triangle here, trying to slice that arm through. And going for the armbar. Gets the hyperextension. The referee's on it. This looks in. Bradley Bunn looking for the finish here, round three. There's the tap, and Bradley Bunn gets it done in the third round.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a fight! Just put your hands together for these young warriors. A victor in round three via armbar, Bradley!